Patel inaugurate the function by lighting the ceremonial lamp.
So sit back and enjoy.
Ma'am, I request you to please address the Vice Chancellor of Parki.
Dean Madam, parents, teacher, and my dear friends. The parent-teacher meeting started in 2002, and it is a brainchild of our Dean Madam. She realized that since a number of students come not only from all over Maharashtra, but also from all over India, it would be a good idea to meet the parents. The idea actually generated from the yearbook of, believe it or not, the grandniece and granddaughter of the truly two great women sitting here, Revati. And when Dean Madam saw this yearbook, she called me and said, Sucheta, wouldn't this be a good idea to implement here as in KEM? We took up this idea, and the naming of this newborn was done by the 2002 batch, and they named it Drishti. Another program called Shidori. Shidori is the food packet that a mother gives a child when he or she leaves home. We hope this tiffin that we give the students will help them to tide over their years in medical college. Preceptors who are members of the staff and associate preceptors who are the senior second year students will help these our grand juniors. These words, I'd like to just show you a small clipping on the Department of Biochemistry and a few inputs about our extracurricular activities that we have at KEM. Second Shidori will involve bedside manners, communication skills, and medical ethics. The third Shidori will talk about the relationship between medical representatives and doctors. Drishti, National Drug 2002, we started in 2002, and we have an interaction between the parents. We hope that we can keep this alive every year. So the extracurricular element recognizes excellence in academics and patient care. These qualities have been carefully nurtured, supported and encouraged by our Dean, Dr. Shirsagar. Dr. Shirsagar is the head of the Department of Clinical Pharmacology. She's also on the editorial board of several journals. She's the recipient of the prestigious BC Roy Award and also Woman of the Year Award in 2003. I request Madam Dean to please enlighten us. Dr.
Jula Patke, Vice Chancellor of the Maharashtra University of Health Sciences, Dr. Bhuyan, Professor Head of Anatomy, Dr. Anjali Doshi, Professor Head of Physiology, Dr. Tandekar, Professor Head of Biochemistry, all proud parents, mothers and fathers of our baby GSites here, and our GSites. People start studying in the 11th, probably in the 10th, but I saw that some parent here is not leaving anything to chance, and they have even got their very young child here. I appreciate how early you can get started. Keep it up, several. No doubt you all work very hard along with your children here to get them all into this prestigious institution. When they come here, some of you might think, but as you can hear from that gasp at the back, they don't expect that actually. They need your continued guidance, help and support. In fact, while entry into the medical college is so competitive and difficult, the medical course itself is very demanding. And let me assure you, all these smiling teachers who are sitting around here today, they don't continue to smile like that. They can be very demanding when it comes to studies and classes attendance and practical classes attendance and also perform performance of your students during various exams. Each and every exam is looked upon by single teacher. Every single teacher looks at every exam as if that is the first that they finish with their studies here with us, 4.5 and then 1 year of internship. They are as good as gold. And they really are. When they finish with us, you name any country and any university in the world, they will accept them with open arms. Of course, we don't want them to leave our country. But we really want them to be made exportable. So these teachers are going to work very hard. The children are going to work very hard. And we all need, really, dear parents, your support. Your continued support is very essential. Some of you may be medical professionals, and therefore you will know exactly the task which the student had to undertake. You will know exactly the troubled times. You will always know as to how to get over these things. But some of you may not be medical professionals. Extremely proud that your son or daughter, one in a family, you may be having a big family tree, and you may be very proud that here you have one of the family members to come to a medical professional. You will be very, very proud, and I'm sure. And they want your pride to increase. You will be more patient with them. You will be more patient with their tantrums. Those of you who stay outside from this city will send them more money, because they will not. You will frequently phone them and ask them as to how are their studies going. But once the exam is over, you will stay away from them, because that's the time they don't want to hear about their parents. They want time for themselves. Then they want to spend time on the katta, adjacent to the canteen. And then they want to spend time with their friends in the nooks and corners of this institution. While we will tell you everything about this institution and about our students, we won't quite tell you everything. There are some things which will remain always secrets between the students and between the teachers, which at an appropriate time you will come to know. Accept some, a few of such things, and wait patiently when you will come to know of such secrets. Talk to your grandparents. Don't tell your parent that you are talking to your grandparents. They may not always appreciate. Do talk to your grandparents. Your grandparents, talking to grandparents has two great advantages. First, they will definitely ensure that they protect you from everybody else in the world. But even a newspaper like Midday, actually, they followed one patient, hoping that they'll find something like a sting operation or whatever it is called. Hoping to find some patient, something where something might have gone wrong in this hospital. And when they followed that patient, they came up with something which they printed in their paper, and they had a one full page cover of it. And they mentioned how at 3 o'clock the patient comes to KM. At 3:10 he's seen by the doctor. At 3:15 he is asked to go and do a blood test. At 3:20 his blood is collected. At 3:30 the blood is in the laboratory, and he is told to come after 2 hours. And how he goes outside and sits on by the tree side, and then after 2 hours he can no longer wait, so he comes inside the hospital to find whether his lab test is done. And the best sentence there was, when he goes to collect his lab report, one smiling face hands over the report to him and says that your report is negative, so don't worry. And I thought that was the greatest thing that I saw during these 1.5 months. Of and as you can imagine, that smiling face was none other than our second MBBS students. You have many things to do in this hospital. Not only to read from your books, not only to learn from your teachers, not only to learn from the internet, which facilities are always available to you in the library, But do learn from this vast laboratory and learning place that is the world, that is the hospital. Do learn your maximum things from it. Also, do do your very best that you can. You can contribute yourself in a great way to the hospitals running and functioning and looking after the patient, which is our primary responsibility. Teaching the students is our next responsibility, and carrying out research is the other responsibility that we have, so that we are forever looking at ourselves as to how we can improvise the patient care, the medical education and the research activities we do. I must tell you here that many of our students are rewarded. They send in a competitive manner their applications to national and international agencies like the Indian Council of Medical Research. Their applications are rewarded with that. Many of them carry out some very useful research work, and which is, I was happy to say, some of them actually have very, very practical applications. So I have many things to do in this institution. So don't be disheartened if you don't do well in one exam. There is always the next exam. Don't be disheartened if the girl sitting next to you doesn't talk to you. There is always another girl. We all together will work towards the institution's motto of not for self but for all. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your heartfelt words. And now I'd like to invite Dr. Khushnuma Mansukhani, an ex-GSI, who is also a clinical neurophysiologist attached to KEM Hospital and Bombay Hospital, and also a parent of our batchmate, Sasha Mansukhani.
Vice Chancellor, Dean Madam, Professors, Parents and Students. Madam, your speech was so stimulating that I feel like becoming a student again. I was so thrilled when Dr. Dandekar confirmed that I was going to speak on this occasion. The last I remember, I was sitting where you all are, desperately trying to keep awake in a morning lecture, or frantically trying to write every word that was whizzing past my ear, like a true GSI. I remember the first day I stood in line to pay my fees. There were two boys ahead of me, and they were discussing genetic mutations. It's cited by the other medical students. In modern day language, it means nerds, but I totally disagree. I was, and I still am, very proud of this institution. I remember our inaugural lecture by Dr. M.L. Kothari. I remember him asking me in a viva, what is the function of the nose? I think he was inspired by the long specimen he saw in front of him. So he brushed aside all my anatomical answers and said, for beauty, in his unimitable sight. Can you imagine two holes inside? Ask parents this opportunity of feeling one with this institute.
Thank you. Dr. Rajan Vaidya, practicing nephrologist attached to Nanavati Hospital and also the parent of our batchmate Smriti Khanna, I request you, sir, to share your thoughts.
Three cheers for all of you, parents and students, for being part of the Gozimek family. Dear children, having been born of such wonderful parents, the second best thing that has happened to you in your life is to have entered Seth G.S. Medical College. Truly, G.S. Medical is like the Oneida ad, neighbors envy, owners. One remembers very well the first few days of anatomy dissection all, and I'm sure you'll have all gone through it. It was the daily headcount of the number of girls who have fainted on entering the hospital. I know of a couple of batchmates who had really nightmares, thinking that the skeletons were reaching near the bed trying to say good morning. The skeletons were sent back uneaten after the first few days of the dissection. Anyway, you'd really get over it. And having finished your dissection class, we had to attend anatomy lecture hall. And we used to really alternate between a professor who was famous for teaching all English and little anatomy, and another who used to teach extremely good anatomy. The other was extremely good anatomy teacher, but of course a little difficult to understand his English. In any case, it was fun, and believe me, next came physiology. And Professor Ramchandani, I feel like taking his name, he was great on most days, especially when the first row was occupied by good-looking girls. And whenever we wanted a day off from physiology, we boys would go and occupy the front seat. And believe me, Dr. Ramchandani would obviously declare a holiday. Then, of course, we had the very saintly Dr. Dharani, who was a friend of one and all and made physiology an easy subject for all of us to understand. In fact, he was found in the library more often than us, giving us an inferiority complex. Biochemistry was fun in the practical class. A little bit of punishment inside the lecture hall. Those days, during our time, we did not have Dr. Dandekar with us. In the first semester, you are still celebrating your entry in medicine. And second semester, you find your bearings and learn to know the nooks and corners of the college, as mentioned by even our Dean, Dr. Sagar. It is important to know the nooks and corners of the college. And of course, final semester, you all become a typical GS Gasu, as my fellow parent, she mentioned. Gasu, she says, is not the right word, but whatever. I mean, that's how a typical GSI used to be called during our times. You suddenly realize that Munna Bhai MBBS was a movie, and in real life, apun ko pass hona mushkil hai. Believe me, GJIs, they did not have this kind of problem. They had the full support of their teachers during examination. And in JJ, even Sanjay Dutt would have passed. Go out of the way to help the students. Like the other day, the JJI, Mr. Prithipal Singh, when he appeared for his anatomy exam in JJ, his examiner said, I'll show you a very simple specimen. And he showed him uterus. And told him, ye kaun sa organ hai jo na tujh mein hai na mujh mein hai. Honestly, Prithipal Singh said, brain. You have to pass them because it was his third attempt, and it's the duty of the hospital to see that the backlog is clear. No such luck for GSI, so you have to struggle and you have to really do well. You go to the wards. We students during our time were very, very sincere and obedient to whatever our seniors said. So when Dr. Pardiwala, our registrar in medicine, he asked my colleague to, while going, just keep a watch on the heart rate of the patient, he promptly took out his new Titan watch and kept it on the patient. We had one registrar, Dr. Chichkar, some of our seniors will remember, and Dr. Monkar was his boss. Now all those who know Dr. Monkar also know how difficult it is to do a term with him. Chichkar was asked to put a rice tube in the patient's nostril. And Dr. Chichkar, after a lot of struggle, could not pass, and Dr. Monkar had already reached the gate. So what he did was an innovative method. He just cut a small piece of the rice tube and introduced it. The job is over. And Dr. Monkar was also very happy. Just when he passed that patient and went to the next bed, the patient sneezed and the royal and of course Dr. Chichkar did not know where to hide himself. I'm extremely proud of all of you, of your achievement, and I'm sure you would convert these 5 or more years into the best time in your life, become famous physicians, surgeons and specialists of national and international repute. And you will proudly carry the label and flag of GS Medical College on your shoulders. So when your dean, and some of you of course would be abroad, and when your dean visits England for whatever reasons, I'm sure all of you all who stay there would gather at the Heathrow Airport and shout at the top of your voice, chak chak achak chak mak, who are we? GS!
Which would Department of Pathology not only teaches us this fascinating subject, but is also a constant source of support and encouragement for all the students.
To add more with the humor as well as the important points which you are supposed to inculcate in you, only one thing I will say, where have you landed? You have landed at the best place. You are the best. We are the best. So let's make the best of it and give the best to the institute. I think you are very proud of yourself that you have this great opportunity to join this twin institutions. Make the best of it and all the best to you. I congratulate all the parents to have come here. I welcome them all. I also would give a word of caution. Please don't worry. Your children are in the best hands. But please do worry when the children need you. Thank you.
I have a parent from outside Mumbai who is going to tell us how students who are from outside Mumbai do well and really do well without getting the facilities of this mega city. I would like to invite Mr. Prakash Chaudhary, MSc Electronics, and also the father of Pranita Chaudhary on the stage for a short speech.
मी नाशिकला असतो आणि मुंबईमध्ये आम्ही पहिल्यांदा इथे आलेलो आहोत. तर जेव्हा इथे ॲडमिशन घ्यायची वेळ आली होती तेव्हा तिथे बरेचसे ऑप्शन्स अवेलेबल होते. एक तर वर्धा होतं, दुसरं पुणा युनिव्हर्सिटी होतं बायोटेकसाठी आणि दुसरं जी एस होतं. आणि माझं बॅकग्राऊंड आहे, मी एम एस सी केलेलं आहे, तर आमचं आता जे काही लेक्चर्स ऐकले आहेत त्याच्याबद्दल मला काही माहिती नाही.
Madam, I request you to release the Drushti 2005 magazine, which is our first collective effort as first MBBS students, and also to please address the audience.
Dr. Manu Kothari, the teacher of teachers. Madam, my friend and colleague, very, very dear parents, and the greatest of the lot, the greatest of the greatest, that is the students of this grand I use the word grand medical college. All of you are very, very happy to be here for this function. In fact, I thank all the organizers for calling the Vice Chancellor for a function like this, because the students know most of the times that the Vice Chancellor has only one role to perform and to see how many students he or she can fail. And then you realize that the GS Medical College is the only college in the state where I could not fail a single student. Last year. So I thought that I must come and visit this college. Of course, I do come here in the capacity of an elder sister to meet my younger sister, your dean, which many of you may not know. But then, when I come here, I feel that this college really is something which is very, very worthy of it. And so I really congratulate all the students and the parents who have been the proud parents today. How did I learn as a pediatrician? And I might just tell you a story, because I saw one small 7-year-old girl there. A pediatrician like me taking a ward round saw a girl, 7-year-old, and I thought that let me ask her now, like a true GSI, you know, communicate well. Dr. Kuyan has already told you. So I asked her, my dear girl, what is the matter with you today?
And I thought that she might say that I can't pass urine properly or my face is swollen. And in your language, I've got edema or whatever she might say. Out came the reply from the 7-year-old girl, "Madam, I've got acute glomerulonephritis." The teachers on the other side and the students somewhere on this side. And then she told me, it is only in GS Medical College that we have such a Shidori and we also have Drishti. And I immediately confirmed looking at the website and also in all the catalogs of MUHS. And I did realize that no medical college, certainly not the Grant Medical College. Remember my good old days at the Grant Medical College. I was not a student of GS. And then Dr. Khanna, I used all the modalities that a Grant Medical student does to pass, and I just managed to get a few medals here and there, and then I came to this position. But I thought that what Grant Medical College lacked, really the GS gains in all respects. And how do you gain? I feel that this is the college which follows all three mottos of three good medical colleges that I had the opportunity to work with. Your own motto, not for self, but for all. I think the GS students do follow that. The second motto is of the Grand Medical College, which I thought I should tell you. And that is, mens sana, corpore sana. What does it mean? A sane mind in a sane body. You have to have a healthy mind and a healthy body. All your teachers mentioned to you that as a student, if you inculcate that one motto of the Grand Medical College, and you will achieve everything. And the third motto is of the BJ Medical College, Pune, which is also worth knowing in simple language, service, duty, and sacrifice. I'm very proud to say, students, that this very college has all three mottos amalgamated together. The other reason of my telling you something today was that I knew a little selfish motive that one of you is going to be the cardiologist of tomorrow, one of you is going to be the neurosurgeon, one of you is going to be a pediatrician. And then I thought that I might need some of you for myself or for my relatives. So I must know how all of you look like. And friends, I must tell you that you look just fabulous. Why do you all look fabulous? Because you have the shine of intelligence, which you have released today, gives you a good vision, not only of the entire GS Medical College, but also of the entire state of Maharashtra and the globe. You all know the story of the hare and the tortoise, which we have learned from childhood. And all of you, like a good hare, have ran and ran and ran and ran fast, and you've always won the race. You know that the moral of the old hare and tortoise story is that we know that slow and steady wins the race. So the tortoise finally ran slowly, 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 and he won the race. But in today's world, that doesn't work out to be true. So what does the hare decide? This is a second story. The hare says, "This is no good. I slept in the middle and so I couldn't run, and the tortoise won the race." So this time, the second time, the hare decides that, "No, I'm not going to sleep, and as a good student, I'm going to run and run fast and win the race." So the second race, the tortoise didn't win, but the hare ran very, very, very fast and he won the race. So what do we say is the moral of the story? Quick and consistent. Maybe we have already done that. But then what happens in the third story? The third story, the tortoise says, "Hey, nothing doing. This hare has been a little too smart. He's very quick and I can't run." So what does the tortoise do? He decides to bring a small river in their path of the race. So when the river comes, the hare has to stop at the river, and the tortoise nicely goes, swims across, and wins the race. So what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story is, if you change your path at the right time, you win the race. And today you have to change your path. And
path that you have taken by entering the GS Medical College. But the story doesn't end here. Now what happens? Fourth time. Now hare and tortoise have seen each other, like how you see the students of Grand Medical College again and again in all exams. And then finally you decide, oh well, doesn't matter. Let's all be friends. So similarly, hare and tortoise both decide that they'll become friends. So they run up to the river, and when the river comes, the tortoise puts the hare on his back, and both of them swim through the river, and in the end, both win the race. What we call as the win-win situation. So, two steps forward, and of course, my dear students are running fast. So they are the ones with our help, and all of us working together, we are very sure that we will win all races. And tomorrow I will see a small little budding Nobel laureate coming from one of you, the student of GS Medical College. My name. We all took our first baby steps into the field of medicine by fumbling around in the world of anatomy, which was quite literally Latin and Greek for us. Dr. Bhuyan, Professor and Head Department of Anatomy, has very ably initiated us into this world. I request Dr. Bhuyan.
Today is a very special day. It's special because it is an amalgamation of two occasions. One is Shidori and the other is parents-teacher meeting. And what is the sole purpose of this meeting?
How can it be made
more easy if you follow what is called as the 5 D's, you know. And what are these 5 D's? You have the right direction, that is one. You are determined, then you should be able to meet the deadline. Okay, disciplined and devoted.
I would just like to share with all of you, you all must be knowing, this time our first MBBS result is really 100%. 100%
because all those who have appeared have passed. There are 9 students who have got distinction in all the 3 subjects. There are 38 distinctions in anatomy, 9 in physiology, and you will get a shock now, 18 miles. Your patients don't bother whether there are D or no D. So what is the main aim then? They would come to you not because of your distinctions, because that's all that you will remember. No one else is going to remember. They'll come to you because of what 5-star. A 5-star doctor is having 5-star qualities. Qualities to be able to be with the patient. What these 5-star are: a good caretaker, a good communicator who is able to talk to you well. Okay? A good community leader, he's able to mix with the community. A decision maker, a good manager.
Umesh Khanna, a gynecologist and an obstetrician, done his MBBS from Lokmanya Tilak Medical College and is the father of our dear batchmate Dr. Vaibhav Vaidya.
तुम्हाला चांगले डॉक्टर, ज्ञानी डॉक्टर, कुशल डॉक्टर बनवण्याचे कार्य नामांकित वैद्यकीय महाविद्यालयातील अत्यंत निपुण प्राध्यापक वैद्यकीय निपुणतेबरोबरच व्यक्तिमत्त्वाचा सर्वांगीण विकास होणं हे अत्यंत महत्त्वाचं आहे. तुमच्या प्रत्येकातून केवळ ज्ञानी आणि कुशलच नव्हे तर एक परिपूर्ण व्यक्तिमत्त्व तयार झालेला एक सुदृढ डॉक्टर निर्माण होणं ही काळाची गरज आहे. एखादा छंद जोपासणं, नियमित व्यायाम करणं, खेळ खेळणं, विविध सामाजिक मॅडम डीन मॅडमने सांगितल्याप्रमाणे विविध सामाजिक समस्यांची जाण ठेवणं इत्यादी गोष्टींवर सुद्धा तुम्ही भर दिला पाहिजे. चार्ज युअर बॅटरीज. याशिवाय व्यायाम, खेळ, शारीरिक आणि मानसिक तंदुरुस्ती याकडे सुद्धा तुम्ही लक्ष पुरवलं पाहिजे. नियमित व्यायाम, खेळ, सकस व पौष्टिक आहार याच्यामुळे शरीर व मन सुदृढ राहतं, कामामध्ये जोम येतो. मित्रांनो, एक लक्षात घ्या की समाजाच्या स्वास्थ्याचं रक्षण तुम्ही करणार तेव्हा तुम्ही सुदृढ व
निरोगी. आफ्टर दिस स्पीच वी ब्रिंग बिफोर यू द ट्रेजर ट्रोव ऑफ टॅलेंट कंटेन्ड विद इन आवर स्टुडंट्स. वी स्टार्ट विथ द एंटरटेनमेंट सेक्शन नाउ एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द डिग्निटरीज ऑन द डायस टू प्लीज टेक देयर सीट्स इन द ऑडियंस.
श्योरली गो फॉर अ टॉस. दिस इज द टाइम टू गेट ऑर्गनाइज्ड. Mnemonics, which have always been your friend, will become your bosom buddy. You do all you can to put yourself on the top of the pile. Competition is intense, but the fruit is sweet. And before you know it, you're through with the rigors of Thor MBBS, and you find yourself an intern. You are now a proper doctor in training. A one-year window period, and then you're through. You're an MBBS doctor. Your struggle was finally worth it. But hark, before you rest on your laurels, you find yourself at the crossroads, again on the threshold of a new life. Onward and up.
Hey, I, Divya Vajpayee, from second MBBS, standing for you to narrate my first-hand experience about entering the enchanting arena of medicine and what message I have learned from it. Just a year ago, I was sitting on the same seat as that over there, awed by the magnanimity of this Seth G.S. Medical College and KM Hospital. I was very happy with my achievements of cracking the entrance exam and getting admission in one of the best medical institutions of the nation. I was really feeling on top of the world. But soon I realized that this was not the end, but the beginning of a new life.
Best SRK, Shah Rukh Khan. Your batchmates will also repeat same dialogues after 4.5 years. Hey ma, hey ma, tu puchti thi na, hey dekh main kya leke aaya, hey dekh main bahu leke aaya ma.
Welcome, Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome, Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom Dad.
Welcome,
Mom
मेरा तो सपना रहने की चेहरा देखे दोस्त को घूमे बाहर मेरा तो सपना रहने की चेहरा देखे दोस्त को घूमे बाहर शालों में खिलती गलियों का मौसम आंखों में जादू फोटो में
Thank you. इंतजार कर रहे थे। अचानक उन्होंने देखा कि उनकी श्रीमती जी चाय का प्याला लिए मुस्कुराते हुए उनके सामने आ गए।
According to the names given at a meeting later on. Now we will move on.